How's it going, everybody? Ben Lowry here. It's a new year and it's a perfect time to be setting goals for the year ahead. And so what you can do is download version 4 of my goal setting spreadsheet, and I'm going to show you how it works right now. All right then, it's quite exciting setting goals. I really enjoy it. There's something creative about it, isn't there? I mean, you can just write whatever you want, really. It's fun. By the way, just before I get into this, first things first, you can download this by going to benlowry.com/download, and there'll be a link to a Google Drive where you can just copy. You should be able to just copy it, okay? Secondly, follow me on Facebook, the Ben Lowry page, which is where I post the updates. And the other thing is, before I get started with explaining about this, I think it's really helpful to tell people what you need. So, because if people don't know how they can help you, then they just don't know, do they? So a couple of things I need. I'm in the market for video editing, video marketing for people. I do promo videos for, you know, just businesses or whatever. So if you know anybody who needs video, put them in touch with me. You can go to benlowry.com/video marketing. And the other thing, I'm looking to do presentations at networking events to talk about my mood app and just do a short talk just to show people the concept, and people find it interesting. So if you know any, like, anywhere where they have guest speakers, like, it, you know, I'm not looking to talk for an hour or anything, but maybe just like 10 minutes or something like that, put them in touch with me. All right. So with that said, let me show you this spreadsheet. Now, so this is version 4. I've improved it a little bit. And what I've done is combines like my own ideas with some of Alex's ideas, who is my coach. And I've just sort of merged it together. I've chosen the bits I like and left the bits I don't like. So there's 5 main tabs at the bottom: the dashboard, the values, the map, the actions, and the ideal partner. Now, the ideal partner one is if you're single and you're trying to decide what your ideal partner is. Okay, so you know, not everybody's going to need that, so you can just delete that if you want to. There's a few other tabs from version 3: the wheel, the mini milestones, and the actions, but they're redundant, so I've left them hidden, so don't worry about that. But I just left them in there just in case you want to have a look at them. But everything I'm going to show you is basically what you need. And okay, so the idea is you choose the time frame you want to work on with goals. So you might want to set 1-year goals, 10-year goals, and it's up to you, you know, 1-week goals, and you can tick whatever time. Now, what Alex, in Alex's system, she gets us to set mini milestones, which are monthly goals for the year ahead. So in other words, 12 monthly goals. And I quite like that. So what I choose to do, this is my preference. I want to be able to deal with today's action steps, stuff that I can do straight away. And then I want month 1, month 2, month 3, month 4, month 5, month 6, month 7, month 8, 9, 10. 11, 12. I like that. That's a time frame that feels good. Okay, so it's up to you, but that's what I'm going with. Now, what happens is on the tabs at the bottom, if you go to the map, it's going to automatically populate these time frames. Okay, so if you choose different time frames, it'll put the different time frames. It just shows whatever you tick. The next thing you need to do is choose the areas of life you're working on. Now, it's I tweak around with this, because I think the trick with this stuff is you've got to keep it simple enough where you're gonna do it. If this kind of thing starts to get too complicated, like version 1 that I did was too complicated. There was just too many action steps, too many parameters, too many settings, and it's like, it's just what happens is you end up not doing it, you know, because it's too fiddly, right? So it's got to be simple enough. Now, I find if I'm trying to set goals for every single area of life, it's too much, because some stuff I don't care about as much, right? As you know, so you got to choose. Alex recommends choosing 2 areas that are the top priorities. So it might be relationship and business, for example. For me, two wasn't enough because I had all my different business project categories, and I find it difficult cramming all the different goals and all the different targets from each one of my different projects into a single category. It's like I need them spread out. So what I choose to do myself, so love and romance is the main one, but the rest are separate business categories. So Igloos, my property investing group, the Hen Party Entertainment, that's a separate business, my video marketing, that's a separate one, my coding and programming is a separate one, public speaking, podcast, that's not so important, I'll leave that out for a second. And then what happens is when you skip across onto, and by the way, you can set your own ones. You can put as many as you want. It's up to you. You can change the names, the tick boxes. You can just drag them down. You can add more columns if you want. It'll automatically. So what happens is when you go across onto the tab, the map tab at the bottom, all these categories are now filled in. So for me, these are the ones I tick: love and romance, Igloo property, Hen Party Entertainment, video marketing, coding, and public speaking. Those are what feels right to me. You just got to go on what feels right to you. Yeah. It's a little bit different for everyone. And now, here's what's cool, right? We've skipped values. I'll have to come back to that in a minute. If you write an action in love and romance, such as whatever, go on a date after, right? If you put that there, and let's do a business goal, Hen Party Entertainment, whatever. Say I want, what should I put? Video marketing, get 3 new clients. All right, I'm just picking stuff out of thin air. What happens is on the actions tab, it's automatically, it left the gaps. Okay, I'll have to fix that. But it's going to automatically on the actions tabs put your immediate actions, but only your actions, right? Does that make sense? And then in the rest of these boxes, you can fill in your monthly targets. Right? So that's simple enough, isn't it? Cool. And then if you choose to have your 5-year, 10-year, 50-year goals, they'll just get added to the bottom. Okay? Look, let me just show you. Let me click on 20-year goal there. Then I go back to the map. And now 20-year has appeared there. Okay? You get the idea, right? Now, the bit we skipped over, which I really like, and this comes from Alex's coaching, is this isn't really goals, but it's more to do with understanding yourself. They're all the different values in life, all the things that are that might be important to you, right? And you can tick as many as you want. There's a huge list on the left hand side. There's like over 100. So let's say achievement, let's say career, let's say anything that jumps out at you. That seems like it's important to you, just give it a tick. So health, order, optimism, love, leadership, doesn't matter, I'm just picking them, respect, power, personal fulfillment, self-expression, safety. Okay, that's enough. So you choose all the ones that jump out of you. Not jump out of you again. And they go on to this sort of secondary list, right? So see, these are the ones that seem most important. Then you're going to whittle them down to the five that seem like they're your top five. And then you're going to whittle that down to the two that seems like your top two, right? And the idea is those are the things that your life is going to orientate. It will automatically, because those are what are important to you. So this is more like a self-reflection, just learning about yourself kind of thing. And you'll find that all the things you want in life and all the things that you make time for and all the things you prioritize are orientated around these sort of core values. Okay, these are what you will try to achieve above all else. All right, they're just like your guiding compass in life. Okay, so that's up to you. By the way, you have to do one at a time, because if you start changing the first column, it'll then mess up the others and all the tick boxes will be out of line. So you got to do the first one first, then the next one in order for it to stay correct, if that makes sense. Okay. One thing I forgot to mention that's really important, and this is another thing I got from Alex that she gets us to do, is future fulfilled, right? Let me make that bold. Now, the idea is this block here, you can describe in more descriptive sort of long form terms. You can write a whole paragraph or as much as you want, describe in detail what it looks like when that future is fulfilled, your business, whatever the category is. So it's like these are all interim steps, but so like 12 months from now, describe the scene, you know, not what it takes to get there, the actual final result, desire, so you can feel what it's like to have accomplished it. So that's where you write that. Okay, so put as much as you want, indulge in it as much as you want, you know, the clearer the better, the more you emotionally connect with it, the better. Like Tony Robbins says, clarity is power, being specific, taking the time to be specific. The more specific you are, the more, you know, chance you got of making it happen. If all the little goals and milestones are just kind of vague, they don't have, you know, if it doesn't really mean anything to you, if you don't feel strongly about it, they don't have any, what's the word I'm looking, they're sort of impotent, aren't they? You know, you want them to be things that are realistic, that you genuinely want, that actually excite you, then it's authentic, then you stand a chance of actually doing them, you know. So this is a chance to be real, you know, and true to yourself about what you really want. So the last tab, ideal partner, who they are, you can describe exactly who they are in as much detail. Who you are, who would you have to be in order to meet that person? You know, are those two things compatible, and how you meet? So it's just getting clear. Clarity is power. That's it, folks. So before I wrap up, we're starting a new year. Do I have anything else left to say? I got loads of other little projects on the go. The Mood app, I'm going to put my first little app out there, which is called Vlogger Blogger. No, it's not. What's it called? Blogger? Blogger Logger. It's for logging anybody like me that does video blogging, and you want to keep a track of all the links and all the episodes, you know, so that you know what you've done and you've got a record of it. It's an add-on for Google Sheets. So that's kind of my first, it's not really an app, it's an add-on, so it's kind of an app. But I'm just starting with that, and the Mood app is a little bit more complicated, but again, I'll put that out there at some point. Yeah, that's it. I don't have anything else to say. Thanks, everyone. Bye.